good athletes in this one. Veronica Campbell-Brown of Jamaica on the outside, twice the Olympic champion. There's Anyika. 23.06. Well, she might have to run in that sort of bracket if she's going to make it through comfortably. Veronica Campbell-Brown on the outside. Debbie Ferguson McKenzie of the Bahamas. There you see her, now 35 years old. Won the world title in 2001, got it retrospectively in place of Marion Jones, who of course was banned. There's Onuora. And on the outside, we'll take a look at Veronica Campbell-Brown. 29 years old, she's run 22.26 this season, and a real gold medal contender.
She is indeed, and this is Debbie Ferguson McKenzie, 35 years old, just keeps going and going, in pretty good form this year as well. And Anyika Onuora, as you said, needs to reproduce that 23.06 seconds that she's run to be in the mix here. Her coach Lloyd Cowan, her training partners Christina Hurugu and Andy Turner. I think it's fair to say that group's having a bit of a mixed week. With Christine being disqualified in the 400 and Andy Turner, of course, winning that wonderful bronze medal in the 110-metre hurdles.
Veronica Campbell-Brown, 10.97 in the final of the 100 metres. She was out in lane 8 and got the silver medal behind Carmelita Jetta, and she's in lane 8 again, just as she was in that final. Starter telling the athletes a few instructions, and Veronica Campbell-Brown, you heard him say, lane 8, can you hear me? Turned round with a little wry smile. Yep, I can hear you, I'm ready. Shouldn't forget Yvette Lalova either in lane 4, the Bulgarian. She was 7th in the final of the 100 metres, a very good 200 metre runner as well. So this is the 5th of the 200 metres semi-finals. Campbell-Brown on the outside has gone out well, also going well in lane 4 is Lalova. They come round now towards the straight, Ferguson McKenzie's in contention as well. And going very easily, Lalova in front, alongside her, Campbell-Brown. Campbell-Brown coming through on the outside, and she wins it. Second place Lalova, third place Ferguson McKenzie. And Onuora, well, I don't think she was in the first four. Maybe that she was back in fifth place. Didn't run a great bend, did she? And then she just couldn't stay with it, as Lalova gave her, in a sense, every opportunity. She was in the lane next to her. Let's take a look at Onuora here. Clear who's gone through as qualifiers up front. Campbell-Brown, Lalova and Ferguson McKenzie. Now here's Anyika Onuora. What do you make of this, Catherine?
Well, in terms of where she was in placement of her lane, Anyika was all over the place. She ran very wide on the bend, came into the straight, and it looks like it's going to be very close indeed. And I think, well, we're getting confirmation through that it might be a personal best for Anyika Onuora at 22.93 seconds, which in itself is great. But she hasn't bagged one of those automatic qualifying spots. She is in fifth.
Beaten by 1/100th of the second. 1/100th of the second keeps her out of qualification places. And Veronica Campbell-Brown winning in 22.46. Let's hear her reaction now. Anyika Onuora is with Sonia.
Anyika, there was an oh my god from you when you realised you've never run faster than that in your life, have you?
Anyone who has been watching me in this sport grow up knows just how much I've been trying to go under 23. It's been ridiculous. And I was telling my coach beforehand, I was like, you know what, I'm feeling good. You know, forget about the heat, forget who's in my race. Every single 200 metre race I've done this season has been into a minus win. And I've just ran that into a minus win. And he's like, no, don't worry, it'll be into a plus win. And it was into like a minus 0.2. So I'm very pleased with that.
Did you look at your lineup here in this heat and you look at it, you know, Campbell-Brown, you've got Lalova, Debbie Ferguson, McKenzie, and think, oh, hello, God, I'm up against it here?
No, you know what? I think this has been a funny championship where you can never write off people like me, but then you can never write off the favourites. I know about the whole who's on the front cover fiasco. You know, if you're on the front cover, it's bad luck. But you know what? I'm just happy to race against these girls and give myself the best opportunity. I always knew, you know, all disappointed after me 100, I could run well in the two, and you know, thank God I have.
Well, I'm pleased to tell you that you are through to the semi-finals as one of the fastest qualifiers, and that's a fantastic smile. How much does that mean to you? And how much further do you think you can go?
Much further. You know, we just wanted to get past the first round. I did the minimal warm-up. I spoke to both my coaches beforehand. Just do what you can, don't overemphasize, because, you know, it was so warm. And I've been on the track since 8:30 as well, so I just have to do what I get to. And I always said I'd aim for the semi-final in this, obviously, you know, as long as I'm in good shape, fit and healthy. And after the year, I've had 2 PBs in 1 year. It's fantastic, I'm over the moon.
And you should be, well done.
Thank you.
So there's confirmation of the qualifiers. Veronica Campbell-Brown, 22.46, the quickest. Lalava looking good. Jetta, easy heat winner, wasn't she? And Alison Felix as well. Going to be a very competitive, very hot 200 metres. And we were worrying, we were fretting a bit for Anyika, but she got there as a fastest loser. And there you see the final list.